Good morning to those of you watching us at home. Hopefully no technical glitches this week. I shall disappear from view in just a second and mysteriously reappear with the gospel book in hand. So the screen will be just a view of the altar for a minute or so. But don't worry, don't adjust your set. The service will be underway very, very soon. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Grace, mercy, and peace from God, our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you. Please be seated. And it's great to see you. We're sort of doing two things today. We're going to mark the feast day of St. Luke, Apostle and Evangelist, who sometimes gets missed out because of the way in which his feast day falls. It actually falls today, and we thought we'd use this opportunity also as an occasion for Harvest Thanksgiving, and thank you to those who placed your harvest gifts in the boxes or around the boxes in the narthex. I'm going to leave the colours, frontals and decorations up for another week, for next week Bible Sunday. I've just decided I'm going to do that, so as you pass on your way out, please take a look at the wonderful harvest wreath prepared by Year 3 at All Saints School. Earlier in the week, they had a harvest Thanksgiving that was compiled by the Deputy Head Rachel Flatman, and for which there were a couple of pieces in church to be played at the right time. So the wreath is by Year 3, and there are a couple of other posters in the narthex for you to look at next time, including a wonderful harvest of hope and a harvest of promises. So without more ado, and with noise it off on All Saints Street, our service begins with our prayer of preparation. We say together, Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments, and to live in love and peace with all. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, give us all that is past, and God, that we may serve you in the newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. At your end, we stand in glory and in mixed justice. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Almighty God, you called Luke the physician, whose praise is in the gospel, is in the gospel to be an evangelist and physician of the soul. By the grace of the Spirit and through the wholesome medicine of the gospel, give your church the same love and power to heal. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah, the 35th chapter. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who are of a fearful heart, be strong, do not fear. Here is your God. He will come with vengeance, with terrible recompense. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then the lame shall leap like a deer, and the tongue of the speechless sing for joy. For waters shall break forth in the wilderness, and streams in the desert. Let us read the stand of the Gospel. The Lord be with you. Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke. After this, the Lord appointed 70 others and sent them on ahead of him in pairs to every town and place where he himself intended to go. He says to them, the harvest is plentiful, but the labourers are few. Therefore ask the Lord of the harvest to send out labourers into his harvest. Go on your way. See, I am sending you out like lambs into the midst of wolves. Carry no purse, no bag, no sandals, and greet no one on the road. Whatever house you enter, first say, peace to this house. And if anyone is there who shares in peace, your peace will rest on that person. But if not, it will return to you. Remain in the same house, eating and drinking whatever they provide, for the labourer deserves to be paid. Do not move about from house to house. Whenever you enter a town and its people welcome you, eat what is set before you. Cure the sick who are there, and say to them, the kingdom of God has come near to you. This is the Gospel of the Lord. May the words of my mouth and thoughts of all our hearts be now and ever acceptable in thy sight. O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Sometimes I think the little homily that I give in the pew sheet is quite enough, and perhaps that's the case today. Just a little test for some of those people who might be keen on words, because we've got the imagery today of the harvest, and we've been hearing about the harvest and wedding banquets in the Gospel narrative of Matthew, which occurs in what we call Holy Week. And can any of you still in school remember the phrase that I gave you, the posh word I gave you, for those things in Scripture that refer to images of the last times? Can anybody remember? Oh, how very disappointing. It means you've got to tell you again. The images, the poetry of harvest and a wedding banquet, such as we heard last week, are what's called eschatological images, because the Greek word eschaton refers to what's going to happen at sort of the end of time. So at the end of time, there'll be this amazing, completely perfect wedding banquet. At the end of time, God's harvest will be gathered and the faithful will be gathered in. And please remember my joke. If you can't remember what eschatological means, it's not the end of the world, but actually it is the end of the world, because eschatological is to do with the end of the world. So please note that tip-top tip from your rector. Okay. Well, I think we've had more than enough over the last few weeks about this kind of imagery, this kind of poetry. My address today might be a little bit more kind of left field. I deliberately chose that passage from Isaiah because it's a very useful epitome of what we're supposed to do. We're supposed to strengthen those who are weak. And strengthen ye the weak hands and confirm the feeble knees is what it says in the Authorised Version. Because God's judgment is surely going to come. We know from previous weeks that it's never too late, or maybe it is too late to turn up to the harvest, to gather in the harvest, and to turn up to the wedding banquet, as long as our inner clothing, not the clothes we wear, I'm wearing today, as long as our inner clothing and our attitudes are right. These are really tough times at the moment, and I spoke about that in a little piece to camera for Dinobi, who are having a documentary made about their work. And this is really tough for basically decent Christian people to remember. And I'm going to remind you what that is. For many years, I had a spiritual director in Lincolnshire. He died a few years ago, and I've not replaced him. And we worked through some spiritual exercises over a large number of years. And a little joke for you, he used to call me your turbulence, not your eminence or your holiness, but your turbulence, because I'd always got the beard in my pocket. And eventually the dust would settle and I'd calm down, and we'd enter into a prayerful dialogue. And I'd disclosed to him my concerns about people I was looking after and A, B, and C. And he said to me, Andrew, what is God's most important gift to you? And I scratched my head, and some of you heard this before, I thought, I can sing a bit. Quite good at books and reading and things, and I used to be quite a good swimmer, believe it or not, when I was a kid, a county swimmer. I'm regarded as a good friend, scratching my head, and I'm sure you know the punchline. He said, Andrew, God's most important gift to you is you. Do what you need to conserve and develop that. Now, we have a few more top tips today in the words from our Lord about discernment. And you know how it is that sometimes we find people around us who are not in any particular kind of need, are completely sort of draining, and we're not sort of energised, and we feel, is this the best use of my time? And in a funny kind of way, that's what Jesus is saying today. He says, don't waste your time, don't waste too much time on people that can but won't. Obviously, there are people who are in continual need, and sometimes what we do can't change their circumstances or their attitude, but we can alleviate the suffering. And there are expressions elsewhere in the Gospel where Jesus says, if you're not welcome, just wipe the dust from the soles of your feet if you're not finding a welcome in my name or in the name of goodness. So I think it's really easy for good Christian people, often, and I'm the worst at this, and sort of continually second-guessing and fretting about what other people might be expecting them to do. Now, we haven't got a lot of time. Well, we've got the time that's allotted to us here on earth. And though we've got to go and feed the hungry, clothe the naked, we have to do that with ourselves, not our selfish, egocentric selves, ourselves, the children that we are in God's eyes. We have to put those at the centre of our lives, because there we find Jesus Christ. There we have our inner clothing, because we put on those garments of humility and openness to the gospel of peace. So this must sound rather extraordinary, an extraordinary message really for harvest, which is about giving and sharing. Make sure before you share, you're doing it willingly, not out of a sense, sometimes misplaced, sense of obligation. Do it because you are genuinely called to do so. Because I think it's better that we live our lives authentically rather than living them in a way that causes us resentment somewhere along the line. So thank you for your harvest gifts today. They will be used in the alleviation of suffering. Times are tough for us, but times are even tougher for those who are being ever more squeezed, and perhaps even squeezed out of their homes and out onto the streets. So balance the duties to yourself with your duties to your neighbour whom you love as yourself. So this year our harvest will be different, but by living lives with integrity and by living lives with ours at the centre, then I believe that God's harvest will come home. Thanks be to God. Amen. Friends, as you're able, please stand to affirm your faith in the words of the Nicene. We believe in one God, the Father and all his own, maker of heaven and earth, all that we have seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God and God, light and light, true God and true Lord, begotten of God. Of one being with the Father, created of all things for men. For us and our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit with the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified on the waters of Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead. In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. We sit or kneel to pray. Christ has no body now but ours, the Church. And we pray for that body throughout the world, remembering today the Episcopal Church of the United States, and for their presiding bishop, Michael Curry. For our brethren in the Church of Sweden, in the Diocese of Växjö, and for our brothers and sisters in the Diocese of Oxford. We pray for our Diocese of Manchester, for our Bishop David, thanking him for his voice in the corridors of power and on the airwaves, speaking up for those who are oppressed and marginalised. We pray for his brother Bishops Mark and Mark. And we pray for this parish of Newton Heath, All Saints, for its work and witnesses, for its continued growth and development, the partnerships established and partnerships to come. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for the world and for their temporary rulers. We pray for all those with responsibility of good governance and containing this noisome pestilence, coronavirus. We pray for our Queen and her government. We pray for a sense of togetherness, that people are conscious in avoiding the risk of transmission of infection to others. We pray for Greater Manchester and our city. We pray that we may be safe, howsoever that's achieved. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. As the people of God in this place, by this church, by law established, we pray for those who live in Hague Street, Hallam Road, Halliday Road, Hapsford Walk, Harmer Close, and Harold Priestley Close. We pray with thanksgiving for the continuing work of our schools and for the remarkable work of all the dedicated professionals and all who support them there. For All Saints and St Wilfrid's, the Briscoe Lane Academy, Christ the King, Co-op Academy at Broadhurst, Bowland Blue Coat, Trinity High School, Otford Hall College and St Ambrose College. We pray that these are places where young people may continue to grow and develop. And professionals may flourish. Lord, in your mercy. Knowing our sins are forgiven, yet we hold before God those things that are bugging us at the moment, those things that are getting in the way of a translucent relationship with our Father in heaven. We offer them up to God at the same time as placing them at the foot of the cross. Pray for those at home or in hospital, all who care for them. We continue to pray for Andrea as she continues to await news about her various conditions. And we pray for Dennis, thanking God for his safe return there. Strengthen for service, Lord, the hands of all those who exercise a ministry of healing and cure. Lord, in your mercy. Amen. We give thanks to God for those who have gone before us in the faith of Christ. And we pray, God, that the Holy Paraclete will be with those who die this day suddenly or unprepared. From our Book of Remembrance, we name Thomas Hatch, May Dodd, Ada Shuttlebotham, Irene Prince, Thomas Graham, John Taylor, and Billy Guy. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon them. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
and to derail peace and to show peace. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God by his body on the cross. We meet in his name and we share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. In a kind of compliant way, let's offer one another a sign of peace. Please be with you. The Lord be with you.
And also
lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, you took flesh, as your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin. He lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We sit or kneel to recall the words of institution. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Wilfrid, St. Anne, St. Cuthbert, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, for honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power and glory, ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bear of our sins, have mercy on us. Draw near in faith, receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ which he gave to you, and spiritually his blood which he shed for you. Eat and drink accordingly in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Amen. The body of Christ. Bless you and keep you, make his face to shine upon you, be gracious unto you, and let his countenance upon you give you his peace. Body of Christ, keep eternal. Body of Christ, keep eternal. Body of Christ, keep eternal. body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ, keep you in turn. Body of Christ, keep you in turn. The Lord bless you, keep you, make his face to shine upon you, gracious unto you. The Lord doth grant his counsel to you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Body of Christ, keep you in turn. Lord God, the source of truth and love, keep us faithful to the Apostles' teaching and fellowship, uniting in prayer and in the breaking of bread, and one in joy and simplicity of heart. Mighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit, to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Thank you to the musicians at St Martin's in the Field in London for this music, and indeed all the music we've been hearing either in church or on social media lately. It's been very, very spoiling for me, and I hope you've enjoyed it as well. Thanks again to All Saints School for providing some of the harvest decorations. And we'll keep them up until next week so people can have a chance to have another look at them. It's lovely to see you and lovely to have some friends here for the first time. And thank you again for the generosity that you've expressed in the gifts that you've placed up in the narthex to go towards the Booth Centre and the mustard tree. Now, next week will be our annual parochial meeting. These are a formality, they are serious, they are required by law. A lot of preparation has gone into them, and historically there's not been much uptake from the congregation, let alone the wider parish, who are able to come to certain portions of it. So as you leave today, you will be given a hard copy of the annual report, a version which you may have received online already. And there will also be the agenda for the next meeting and the minutes of the last meeting of the APCM. There are some very basic figures for the financial year 2019 to give you some indication of where we are, and a very basic indication of where we are in relation to the previous year. So the annual program meeting, which won't take very long, will be within the service next week. Now please don't let yourself be put off by that. It's very, very important we engage in the work of the church outside worship time. I know that there are some, and quite rightly, and we quite understand that you have to kind of top up and recharge. But the stuff that happens here doesn't happen by magic. There's a lot that's going on behind the scenes. And some people have been approached about helping to share those joys, those duties and joys, and also we'll be seeking to need to replace a few members on the parochial church council. And as you come in next week, there'll be some nomination forms in the narthex. We also need to appoint church wardens and other church officers. If you have some curiosity about what those roles might involve, for now or for the future, please get in touch. If you are regular here and yet I don't have permission to communicate with you via email, please let me know. I think there are a couple of people who are fairly regular now, and I don't think we've got formally their consent for their data to be used in that way. It's just a sign of the very officious times in which we live. So the APCM is next week, Bible Sundays, bring your Bibles. The following week is our Patronal Festival, the Feast Day of All Saints, which actually occurs on All Saints Day. We will also use that as an opportunity to remember those we love but don't see anymore. So I'm afraid another list which will put in a safe place in the narthex. Please write down or telephone, but email through to me or phone to me those who you would like to be named next week at remembrance of the faithful departed, which will take place both at the 9 o'clock and at the 11 o'clock. But happily within the 11 o'clock we'll be admitting Renee to membership of Christ's Church through the sacrament of baptism, and admitting the twins to reception of Holy Communion now that they're rising 7. And it seems a kind thing to do for the sake of their mum, if nothing else. So it'll be rather muted affair in comparison with previous years, but that's just the times in which we live. Apologies if it's freezing cold. Steve Millwood came on Wednesday. The part that we need to replace in the boiler is obsolete, but he's found something on the internet which he can bash into shape. The part comes on Monday, he's coming on Tuesday or Wednesday to insert it into Bertha, so God willing. We will have heat next week and thereafter, but just a reminder, to have the heat on overnight to take the chill off this place is about £120, which is an awful lot of money. But as soon as we can afford convecting radiators, four in here to have on for 1 hour of the service, That's what we've got to do. And these convecting radiators are about 10 grand plus VAT. And I think we can get the VAT back on that, but even so, that's a lot of money. Right, enough of me. What about you? Any birthdays coming up this week? It's my late mother's birthday today. If she were alive, she'd be 93. As things stand, as of a few weeks ago, I haven't had it. So that's quite a sacred thought. Is it okay? 102. Okay. Right, any other wacky anniversary, anything like that, any good news to share? There's one young lady I'm going to in Paris now because she's here, and that's to say Jess O'Neill was elected head girl at St Wilfrid's. So now you're actually here, Your Royal Highness, let's give a round of applause. Jess needs to go on Paris. I look forward to greeting you in a social COVID compliant way, and please take home the report which I've prepared with great care. There are illustrations for amusement. And I look forward to seeing you next week. And I promise you won't be unduly detained by the AGM. I would be greatly affirmed and supported if you were able to give it all time. I'll let her to be voted because he has work commitments, so he has to be off. And for those of you watching at home, I'm back. So love your neighbour as yourself, which means you love yourself first. Do those things that you need to do that enable you to get from one week's end to the other, causing your friends, neighbours, and even your enemies as little inconvenience as possible. Because the harvest is plenty, the labourers are few, but we are called, and it's never too late to join in the harvest or to come to the wedding banquet. As you're able, please stand for God's blessing. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Amen.